Hello everyone. So in the last class, we already discussed about architecture and sculpture, and today I'm going to discuss about the paintings. Okay. Indian paintings. So Indian paintings has a very long tradition and history in Indian art and culture. Okay. So here the earliest paintings were the rock paintings, and for example Bhimbetka rock shelter are about 10,000 years old. Okay, 10,000 years old. So we can divide it the Indian paintings, especially so ancient Indian paintings of ancient India can be divided into two categories. First is murals, and the second is miniatures. Okay, murals and miniatures. See, murals are large works. Okay, the murals are large works executed on the walls of solid structures. Okay, and the miniatures. So miniatures are executed on books or albums and especially on perishable materials like paper and cloths. Okay, we found some smaller paintings or miniature paintings on books and cloths and albums. So especially those books were the biographies. Okay, the biographies. So the biographies of rulers, the biographies of rulers like Mughal rulers. Okay, for example, Mughal rulers. So here, paintings were made in both styles on walls of Ajanta. See. Walls of Ajanta in Maharashtra, Bagh in Madhya Pradesh, and Sitanavachal in Tamil Nadu, Aramalai in Tamil Nadu, cave based. So the large works which are known as murals, they are especially executed on especially caves. Okay, caves. So here Ajanta and Ellora caves paintings are world famous. Okay, so see. From 10th century AD, smaller paintings were done. From 10th century AD, the smaller paintings were done in the barks of the Chasi tree. Hasi gosar pat bole je ko ami he hasi gosar pat ba hasi gosar bakolitu hasi bihekoi bakolitu hasi gosar bakolit ki hoy ami hasi patar puthi bole je koy he hasi gosar bakolitut ki hoy likha hoisile aro logote tat kora hoisile kisuman chobi oka hoisile so Chasi tree and silk cloth especially in Assam. Okay, especially in Assam, Rajasthan, Orissa, Mysore, in Karnataka and Tanjore, etc. So here see, we found folk paintings in Bihar, Assam, Orissa, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, etc. So here we found eight folk paintings, see, known as Madhubani. Madhubani paintings in Bihar, Pattachitra in Orissa, Pithora in Gujarat, Kalamkari through this painting made with pain. So in Andhra Pradesh, Kalamkari in Andhra Pradesh, then Kalighat Pat art in West Bengal or Kolkata. And floor paintings are known by different names in different places of India. Okay, then Warli art in Maharashtra, and Thanga painting, especially the Tibetan folk painting is famous in India. Okay, India also. So these are eight folk paintings which are found in India. Okay. So again, see, to execute paintings, one should know the main six skills, okay? Six skill are known as sarangas. These six skills known as sarangas of paintings, okay? So see, first the shape, then measurement, then third point feelings, expression techniques, okay? And after that artistic presentation, knowledge of similarity and rule of using brush, okay? So these are the six rules or six skills or six sarangs. Six meaning sarang, six sarangs of saranga of paintings, okay? And especially see, again, now came to the colors. Now come to the colors. So how the ancient people or ancient artists actually made the color, okay? See, so they use what? Turmeric, sindoor and earthworm and some flowers also, okay? Again, especially from the natural objects, okay? Some from natural objects they extract the colors for their paintings, okay? And see, especially from the Mughal era, okay? From the Mughal era, especially we found some miniature paintings, okay? So in this miniature paintings in biographies or autobiographies of the rulers, Mughal rulers, okay? So see, this painting, skills of paintings are patronized by Akbar, Jahangir and Shah Jahan. So here the biographies of the Mughal emperors, we found the miniature paintings, okay, or smaller paintings, miniature paintings or smaller paintings which are executed on book or albums, okay? And again, see, some examples are given in your book. So among pictorial books meaning where we found the pictures, okay, of that time important were Patsha Nama, Tuti Nama, Jahangir Nama, Dastane Amir, Khansa, etc., okay? So Parsi style of painting was also used in pictorial descriptions of Hindu religious books, okay? So here, see, India, so this chapter is about the cultural heritage of India and Northeast region, okay? So see, so we found here what? Diversity and unity in the same page, okay? So here, what the multiculturalism or the mixture of other culture, mixture of various cultures in India, or the skills of painting, skills of architecture, skills of sculpture designing, that are both are Muslims and Hindus or Parsi, these are mixed together, okay? Mixed together, and at last we found the result is what? The Indian paintings, Indian architecture, Indian culture, etc., okay? So again, in the two epics, Ramayana and Mahabharata, we found smaller paintings or miniature paintings, okay? And again, see, the murals in the caves, and especially on some palaces, the walls of palaces or the peak of the palaces, we found some murals, okay, or large paintings. So let's start the point number 5.06, the music and dance. So again, see, India has a rich cultural heritage in music and dance, okay? So from the Vedas, from the time of Vedas, okay, or Vedic period, first Vedic period starts from 1500 BC, okay, 1500 BC to 600 BC, and after that, after 600 BC, 1500 BC to 1000 BC Vedic period, and 1000 BC to 600 BC it's later Vedic period. So see, the Sama Veda is about what? Music and slokas, okay? So here, see, priest song udgata udgata for the appeasement of deity or appeasement to pray the deity pray the god to appease him appease the god they the priest which recite what udgata okay so here letter A states udgata were divided into various groups depending on just changing styles of singing or of slokas okay so we can say that this udgata as prayer okay as prayer again see the classical music so the classical music of India we see what the guru shishya relationship or guru shishya tradition okay so here in music the most important thing is what the instrument okay the instrument see this instrument among those instruments we found the shehnai tabla santur sitar bina flute dhol dotara then sarinda nupur khol midranga nagara tal etc okay and see you can see the pictures of this instrument in google okay again see dance so like music dances have also a very rich tradition in India so the eight dances of the country have recognized as the classical dance form okay so they are Kathakali Kathakali in Malayalam and Kerala okay so Mohiniyattam in Kerala and Bharatanatyam from Tamil Nadu Kuchipudi from Andhra Pradesh Odissi in from Orissa Kathak in northern India Manipuri from Manipur and Satriya from Assam okay so these eight dance form were recognized by the are recognized by the Indian government as classical dance forms okay and see Natya Shastra from between 200 BC Bharat Muni 200 BC Bharat Muni composed in Natya Shastra okay and here in Natya Shastra the drama about music about instruments about dance these are outlined or these are mentioned in about 6000 slokas okay in 6000 slokas about this drama music and dance okay by Bharat Muni so now come to the yoga culture so again see yoga is a traditional Indian culture and now became its world famous and what happened the 21st June is the International Yoga Day okay yoga day so see who introduced yoga so Patanjali so Ramdev already introduced us with Patanjali okay not only with the person Patanjali but his products also okay so see not actually Patanjali's products it's Ramdev's products okay so see from Indus Valley civilization from Indus Valley civilization we found what this yoga culture okay and not actually from Indus Valley civilization before that okay before that so see the Pasupati Sil we found a Pasupati Sil in the source of this first source of this the cultural heritage of India okay so in Pasupati Sil what happened a person sitting on a what sitting like a yogic posture okay so this is the evidence okay so this is the evidence we found from Indus Valley Civilization. And Patanjali, Maharshi Patanjali compiled a book known as Yoga Sutra. Yoga Sutra. And in the second century, and from that we found what? This yoga culture. Okay, yoga culture in the shape of book. Okay, in the shape of book we found. So here see, in your book there mention about Ashtanga Yoga rule. Okay, Ashtanga Yoga rule by Patanjali Yoga system. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyan and Samadhi. These are the 8 rules of Patanjali Yoga culture. So you can note it down. Okay, see 8 rules or 8 limbs. Okay, 8 limbs of yoga, Patanjali Yoga. See, Yama. Yama means first one. Yama means what? Restraint. Moral disciplines and moral vows. Okay, so before you start your yoga, yogic posture, you have to take vows. Okay, so after that, niyama. So positive duties or observance. Positive duties and observance. Then asana, posture. Okay, then pranayama, breathing techniques. Pranayama means breathing techniques. Anulom, vilom, brahmari. These are the pranayamas. Again see, pratyahara. Pratyahara means sense withdrawal. Sense withdrawal. So sense withdrawal from this world. Actually, from this world, when you meditating or when you are in yogic posture. Okay. Then see, dharana. Dharana means focus or concentration. Dharana means focused or concentration. And dhyana. Dhyana is meditation. And then samadhi, bliss or enlightenment. So bliss or enlightenment, meaning here is you find what? The eternal peace in your mind. Okay, the eternal peace in your mind. So these are the 8 rules or 8 limbs of yoga. Okay, Ashtanga rulers, Ashtanga Niyama or Ashtanga Yoga rule. Okay, Ashtanga meaning 8, Saranga meaning 6. Okay, here Saranga of paintings, 6 skills of paintings, and here Ashtanga Yoga rule. Okay, so that's all for today's class. So in the next class we start the Northeast region. There about Northeast region, about its boundary, about its multiculturalism, about its architecture, religion, sculpture, folk culture, etc. Okay, so if you have any doubt, then you can join the doubt clearance class. Okay, so goodbye.